So around late 90s, Royal Enfield came up with the idea of a laid-back urban cruiser with ape handlebars and forward set foot pegs. And later on in the year 2000s, it evolved, or I'd say leveled up, to the Thunderbird 350 and the 500 considerably. And over the last 20 years, it's got its own set of, let's say, improvements over the previous models. And then came the Thunderbird 350X. Well, it did look more mature compared to the older Thunderbird 350, but there was still, it was, you know, lacking that evolve factor around it. So today we have this, the Royal Enfield Meteor 350, and I can certainly assure you, this is what an evolved Thunderbird 350 should look like. Let's not mess around. Does it still vibrate the bones out of your body? Well, we did find out, and well, it did not. The Meteor 350 is considerably refined when compared to the old Thunderbird 350 or even the 350X. The new motor is so smooth and so refined, and the gear shifts are on spot. Like, if you're looking for a comfortable urban tourer which can do low speeds at higher gears, let's say 35 km/h at fourth gear, it does it quite peacefully. The brakes are really good. They are a little bit rear oriented, so you have to use the rear brakes more compared to the front brakes, but that's okay because it's an urban tourer and these tourers are generally meant to have the rear brakes used more often compared to the front brakes. But still, the brake bites are way better compared to the Thunderbird 350, so that's a big plus. The seat, well, to speak about it, the Thunderbird 350 was already a very comfortable bike. The same is true for Meteor 350, and honestly, it does the job quite well. And also, the new chassis is a considerable improvement over the old one. Yes, the wheelbase might be a little bit longer compared to the old Thunderbird 350, but it doesn't change the fact that this handles way better than the old Thunderbird 350. Well, it feels quite nimble, it feels light on its feet, and honestly speaking, it doesn't feel like a 191 kg bike once you start riding it. And surprisingly, taking U-turns is not a big task when it comes to this. I thought it would be a very big issue when it comes to Royal Enfield, as they are notorious for being very heavy. The gearbox, they have reworked it and it has done its magic. You can just slot into any gear, and surprisingly, it's very easy to get it in neutral. So every time you have to stop, you don't have to play around with the gear lever to find the neutral. It's quite easy on this one. So that's again a very big improvement compared to the old Thunderbirds or even the old Royal Enfields, as a matter of fact. So post-ride, well, it's safe to say that just like the BS6 Himalayan surprised us with its refinement and performance, the same is true when it comes to the Meteor 350. It's way refined, it's way smoother, the gearbox, thank goodness, it's easier to find the neutral, by the way. So if that's a factor for most of you people, so it's a good choice. And also, like, considering different bikes, because let's just say it's supposed to be more heavier, you'll have a problem if you're tiptoeing or not. Honestly speaking, like I've said earlier, I'm 5'6", I can flat foot easily, and you also have the option to customize your seat. So you can even get a lower seat if you want. And handling wise, as we have said earlier in our video, it comes with a new chassis, so it's way stiffer and you can see the difference when you ride the bike. So it's way more agile. It's not supposed to be agile, don't get me wrong. I wouldn't recommend you to get into a corner like you do on an everyday retro classic motorcycle, but this can handle it quite well. It's supposed to be a laid back ride over the canyons, or maybe your intercity rides or something as such, because it's supposed to be known as an urban tourer and does the job quite well. Again, the same, you know, you say a nitpicking or something, it would be great with a 6-speed gearbox. It would be amazing, honestly speaking. Then only thing is, when it comes to the touring perspective, the difference between this and the Himalayan would be, if you want to involve off-roading, Himalayan's the pick. But otherwise, if you want to go everywhere else and face bad patches and whatever it is, this will do the job quite perfectly. The suspension's better, it's smooth. it's not as good as the Himalayan, but again, Himalayan was also meant for the off-road purpose. So you cannot compare them as such. The only thing would be the touring perspective. That's about it. But otherwise, everything is new. The looks are from the Thunderbird 350, which is fine. There is nothing bad in that. The engine is way smoother. Yes, you have the thump. Before people start asking us down below in the comments, it has the thump. It has that minimal vibration. Yes, it's way smoother. You won't have that dug 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 dug. Wait. You know, every part of your bone is vibrating, but it has that feel, which is the most important fact for, let's say, a Royal Enfield purist. So that's there, it hasn't lost it. Again, 20 bhp, 25.7 Nm of torque. Well, it's making its own statement. It's not looking to compete against other bikes in the market. It's making its own stand. It's targeted towards people who just want to go from point A to point B. Even if it's a long distance, they don't want to go too fast, maybe chill around 100 kmph all day long. This bike does it quite well. Compared to the old Thunderbird 350 that had 2 gauges, this has only 1.5. So what you get is speedometer, digital odometer, 2 trip meters and a gear shift indicator along with a fuel gauge. The smaller dial, it shows you the turn-by-turn navigation once you have paired it up with your mobile phone. I like how Royal Enfield have gone that extra step and given those old retro kind of a handlebar controls for your engine kill switch and ignition and the light settings. Yes, you need to get used to it, but it's not a big deal. Okay, you're sold on purchasing the Meteor 350, but that's not about it. What you can do is go to the Royal Enfield website or the My Ride app, and what you can do is customize your own Meteor 350. If the data what we have is right, you can have almost 5 lakh different specs for the Meteor 350. You have 8 different road legal exhaust options, a variety number of crash guard options. You can have a taller windshield or even a smaller one. You can have a shorter seat or have different upholstery. You can have a different backrest. So these are just a few, you know, options provided by Royal Enfield itself. You don't have to spend more money on it. So a final verdict: you want to go from point A to point B, occasional long rides, want to be as comfortable as possible, and it doesn't bother you who passes you around or who you pass at what speeds, this bike is definitely a good choice. So I would like to thank Brahma Motors for letting us ride this bike and provide this review for you. And let me know down in the comments below, like, how do you like it? Which spec would you like it in? And again, if you have any suggestions, any comments, whatever, they are all welcome down below. I'm Kiran, and I'll see you later.